My granddaughter was asleep, but my son had the plugs on his ear, so he probably did not know when it actually started. But can I just stand here and give God some praise, though, because he gave me favor. I might have lost a whole lot of stuff. I lost a lot of clothes because I love some clothes. I lost some shoes because I love some shoes. I lost my furniture. I lost my table. I lost the perfume. I lost almost everything. But can I stand right here and say I did not lose my place? Hallelujah! You can't take that, devil, because greater is he that's in me that's in the world today. Amen? Hallelujah. Bless the name of the Lord. I'm excited. Amen? He favored me.
Yes. Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Yes. Let me get to the task that I was told to do.
Yes.
Your thing was a pastor preaching through every season.
Yes, amen.
Yes, come on. Yes.
Wow.
Yes.
Woo. I said, I hope they got the right person. But I'm going to do the best I can. Amen?
Amen.
If you could stand back up real quickly, let me just say this. This woman and this man, Bishop and First Lady Porter,
mm-hmm.
I've been knowing them quite some time.
Mm-hmm.
And they are friends of mine. But they're not a friend that have to call every day. They're not a friend that have to call every week.
Mm-hmm.
They're not friends that they have to call every month. Matter of fact, they can skip a year or two. But when they call and say, we need you. Or when I call and say, I need you. That's when you know you got a real friend. Because they step in. They'll turn everything away to do things for you. That's what a friend does. And they must know the best friend that you can have today, and his name is Jesus. He can be your best friend today. Turn your word into the scripture. 2 Timothy 4, 2 and 5. I'm going to read one as well. So 1 through 5, I will read.
Mm-hmm.
And the word of God says, I charge thee, therefore, before God and the Lord Jesus Christ,
mm-hmm.
who shall judge the quick and the dead
mm-hmm.
at this appearing and his kingdom.
Mm-hmm.
Verse 2, preach the word,
mm-hmm.
be in season,
mm-hmm.
out of season, reprove, rebuke, exhort with all long suffering and doctrine. For the time will come when they will not endure sound doctrine, but after their own lust they shall heap to themselves teachers having itching ears, and they shall turn away their ears from the truth and shall be turned into fables. But watch, though, in all things, endure affliction,
mm-hmm.
do the work of an evangelist,
mm-hmm.
and make full proof of ministry.
Mm-hmm.
You may be seated.
Amen.
I'm going to be focusing on this one verse. I read 1 through 5, but verse 5 is the one that I want to work with on today.
Mm-hmm.
And it says, but watch. Though in all things endure affliction, do the work of an evangelist, and make full proof of ministry. Most of you don't might not know me, but I'm Brenda Ann Hunter. I have had four kids, but three is only living. And I have four grandkids that I adore. Two of them are boys that are twins, and their birthday party is today at 12:30. My daughter, my granddaughter, who the oldest is 15, and then I have another granddaughter who is 2. And I don't know what I'm going to do with her, but we're going to try to do the best we can. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen.
Amen.
At 50 years old, I went back to school. I thought that was crazy. Pastor Carter, just in case I didn't say this, Dr. Christopher C. Carter Sr. is my pastor at New Hope Baptist Church. But he told me to go to school because I will be standing in front of you and I need to know what to do. And I looked at him like he was crazy, flipped twice. And you did say not to talk about nobody, didn't you? Okay, but I did look at him like he lost his mind. Hallelujah. I am 50 years old. I am not going back to do no school for somebody. But
however,
I went back. I went to play with it for a little bit. So I went and got a certificate of pastoral care. Amen. And I went back and I did it. And so I met some great people. Some great people. I met some men of God and women of God who was sure enough crazy about the Lord. And I said, well, if they that crazy, maybe I need to go a little further. They said, you can do that. So I went a little bit further and I went and got my associate degree. I went and got my bachelor's degree. I went and got my 2 master's degree. Then I went and got my doctorate. And I said, oh, that's enough. Hold right there. Oh, just hold right there. That's enough. And the lady said, you're going to be having a school, so you need to just go one more row. And I said, what? I don't think I can do that. I took all my money. You know what I'm saying? So I think I better stop right here. But guess what? I went 2 more years, and I have 2 PhDs. Amen. Thank praise God. Grace Bible College Theology and Seminary. Not only that, I am the president of the school that's right here in Hampton, Virginia. Amen. Do we serve a great God? God chose favor. Nobody but God. I didn't think I could do it, but God did it for me. Amen. He gave me the money and everything. Amen. That's why the Bible says, give and it shall be given unto you. Place down, shake it together, running over. Men will give to your bosom. Because I done paid a full report because God said give. So when I gave, she gave back. Amen. Bless the name of the Lord. Amen. That's the kind of God we all serve. Amen. Not just me, but you too. Amen. Hallelujah. Okay, let me get my subject today is, but watch what God will do for you. Watch, Bishop. I heard you say you got a vision. It's going to come to pass. Amen. Amen. Let me pray. Our Father and our God, I'm only standing here because of your grace and your mercy with the loving kindness that you show me by when you touched my lips this morning and woke me up, oh God. But now it's preaching time and I need the Holy Spirit, oh God, to touch me from the top of my head to the sole of my feet that I would meet every need that you have told me to do. Now, God, guide my tongue of clay, oh God, that I only say what you have told me to say, oh God. We love you because you first love us in Jesus' name. Amen. Bishop, I want to thank you for letting me stand here in your place. You didn't have to do it because you already done preached some of it already for me. So I'm going to give you 10 minutes. Y'all got 10 minutes? How about that? Amen. To this leading woman right here, precious doll. Amen. I love to see a woman working by her husband. Amen. Side by side. I ain't seen her do nothing else but be with her man. Amen. And yes, he is still cute. Hallelujah. Every time I call him, I say, he cute. Amen. Amen. It ain't changed. He cute. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Those are my friends. Bishop, I looked up. Thank you for allowing me to be here again. I looked up the number 16. And it's divided by two, which is the number eight. Amen.
Yes.
Amen. It's a number that means completion.
Yes.
Amen. It's not just that, it's a number that also means you have overcome some struggles.
Yes.
Amen. I didn't know this till I looked it up. That's why I went to school, so I can learn some things. Amen. So I went a little further and it said, it's not just 16. 16 also means that you've been taking care of yourself and others.
Amen.
I said, oh wow, this is beautiful right here.
Yes.
It said the number 16 represents finding balance in life.
Yes.
Now, I know that's true because they have two kids, amen. And when I walked in the office, the daughter was married.
Uh-huh.
That tells me that they've been doing some training, amen.
Uh-huh.
Amen. I saw that, so wow, that's wonderful. Finding balance in life. Taking initiative. He's a man to go forth and take initiative. He said he got a vision.
Yes, yes, yes.
And it's going to come to pass. Amen.
Amen.
He also put things in action because when I walked in, I saw some more room.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
Mm-hmm. I said, oh, he done put some things in action. We got, oh, this anniversary, that anniversary.
Uh-huh.
Oh, my God, going around the world. I said, oh, my God. He's a man in action.
Amen.
He's also a man of wholeness.
Amen.
Okay? He's independent.
Mm-hmm.
God has placed him because he already chose him as pastor. Amen?
Amen.
Overcoming obstacles.
Mm-hmm.
He's doing it. He's personal willpower, and I see y'all in unity. Amen?
Amen.
You're in unity. Amen. I can see when he comes up. This is definitely shows the characteristic of Bishop Porter. Amen.
Amen.
And Lady Porter standing beside him.
Amen.
So, Pastor, keep on preaching through every season. Long as you got God by your side, you will never lose.
Amen.
Now, let's get to the word.
Amen.
The book of 2 Timothy was written in 67 AD while Paul was in prison in Rome. But after a while, he was out of prison for 2 years with some freedom. He was arrested again under Emperor Nero. The purpose of this book while it was written was to give the final instruction to Timothy. That's why it's 2 Timothy. Timothy, who is the elder of the church. Amen. He's a preacher, y'all. Amen. He's a man of God. Amen. Amen. He is in charge right now. Now, Timothy is charged to preach the gospel so that the Christian faith was spread throughout the world. You have the same charge. To preach the gospel. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. The same charge. This not only is just for him, it's also for every one of you. Because when you said, I'm committing myself to God, you are saved now. That means you're supposed to be out winning souls.
Amen.
We all have the same purpose. Amen. Amen. Throughout this world, preaching to the people of God, bringing them in the church. Amen.
Amen.
This is the same charge. Amen. That we preach and teach for today. There are three important points in verse 5, that I want you to remember.
Amen.
Number one, the word watch.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Mm-hmm. Number two, the word endure. And number three, the word work. And he already did that working thing already for me. Amen. As a pastor, overseer of the church, or as a child of God, that means you. It is necessary to watch. The Bible says in Matthew, watch therefore, you know not the hour that the Lord cometh. Amen?
Amen.
The Bible didn't stop there in Matthew. It went on and said, watch and pray.
Yes.
That we may not enter into temptation. The spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak. I got happy over that scripture because I went a little further about watch. This is the good one that stands out the most from that happened to me. Psalms 121, 7 and 8. The Lord will keep you from all harm. He will watch over your life. And the Lord will watch over your coming and going both now and forevermore. God puts a responsibility on himself. that he would even watch us while we doing the work for him. That's the kind of God that we serve today. If he give you any orders, he give you anything to do, he's going to be right there watching you. The Holy Ghost that lives inside of you will not let you go left if you don't need to go left, and it will not let you go right if you don't, if you're listening to the Holy Spirit. But you gotta be watched. I love when the young man got up and prayed. He said, y'all bow your heads and y'all close your eyes, and that was wonderful, that was good. But somebody in the back better be watching.
That's right.
It says watch as well as pray. I need at least one person watching. Amen. At least one. Amen. Because anything you need to do is protect the man of God. We got to protect him. He's our leader. He gets the word from God. Amen. Amen. And then you can trust him. Now let's talk about the next word, endure. As a pastor, the overseer of the church, as you, as the child of God, that's us, amen? It is necessary to endure, which it means to remain firm in a commitment to be true to the commandments of God, despite temptations, oppositions, and adversity. The Bible says in 2 Timothy 3:11, persecution, affliction, which came unto me at Antioch. What persecution I endure, but one, but out of them, all the Lord delivered me. Now let's stop right there. Have you ever been in a place with God and he have asked you to do something that's like, real crazy? But when you got in it, you wasn't quite sure how you was going to come out of it. But when it ended, he was right there, and he delivered you out of it all.
Amen.
I've been in that place, amen? That God had asked me to do something to step out. Let's think about the man Peter. God told him to come on to the water. And he got on the water. If he had not lost focus, he could be still walking right now. But because we get our focus, us, amen, us, all of us, when we get our focus, we sink.
Amen. Come on.
But even when we sink, God still picked us up. He sits up high, y'all. He looks down low, and he still know how to meet every need. My God, my God. Job says in the B clause, I'll wait until my change come. You're going to go through a problem. You're going to go through a situation. You're going to go through trials and tribulation. But you still got to
wait.
And while you're waiting, just take this word, believe. He said he gave us all a seed, a mustard seed, a faith. So that's in everybody. Amen. But we gotta take that little faith we have and grow it on a daily basis. We gotta watch, y'all. And then we gotta endure. We gotta endure. He's the joy of our strength. We got to endure. When the pain hits, and we got to endure. Talk to the Lord. Amen.
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 I know that's right.
As a pastor.
Amen.
And the overseer of the church.
Amen.
Or as a child of God for us.
Amen.
It is necessary to work.
Yes. Yes.
From the beginning of, look, I found this in the beginning of the book.
Yes. Come on.
work.
Work.
But what got me, if you got your Bibles, Genesis 2 and 3. Mm-hmm. It says, and God blessed the seventh day. And sanctified it. Because in it he had rested from all his
work.
God worked.
Yes.
Which God created and made.
Yes.
I said, well, if God worked,
you gotta preach. You gotta preach.
We're talking about the Most High.
You gotta preach.
Yeah. Come on, tell it.
That created everything in the world.
Yes.
It says he worked.
Yes.
This Bible is something, y'all.
Amen.
That's why it's good to read it sometimes.
Amen.
Because if you read it and look at it, I really never paid that much attention. I'm just being honest, amen. But God worked.
Amen.
Worked
by God.
God worked.
Amen.
So how come? No, I better not say that.
Come on.
No.
Tell it. Go ahead.
Well, how come the preacher's not working?
Come on.
This one is.
I know you work, Bishop.
Come on.
Well, how come that you're 21 years old and don't think you're supposed to work?
Yeah. Come on. Tell it. Uh-huh.
I was working at 14 years old.
What was that?
Today.
Yeah,
hallelujah.
Yeah.
Oh, and don't leave out the mac and cheese. Oh my God. Anybody got some sweet potato pie before Thanksgiving? Let me know.
Yeah, I got
that.
Yeah.
If the Bible says you don't work, you don't eat, something is wrong with us that don't want to go to work.
Amen.
Outside the church.
Yeah.
We gotta appreciate things like that.
Yeah.
I did not understand when my mother was making 75 cents an hour and I wanted a $200 job. What was wrong with me? But because she loved me. Because she loves me. And because God loves us. He just keep going and going and giving and loving. That's the kind of God we serve, y'all. He said he blessed the seventh day and sanctified. And he rested. Amen. Proverbs go on 14:23 teaches us in all labor there is a profit.
Yes.
Did y'all hear that?
I heard it.
I was up early this morning, 3:00 in the morning, looking this stuff up, y'all.
Uh-huh. Amen.
If you work, it's a profit for you.
Yes.
And I know it's right because if he says give your tithes and if you only give it 10%, that means I get 90.
Amen.
Well, that's a good figure right there to me.
Yes.
Y'all better be glad I'm not God. I want 50%. True to that since I've been at I was at St. John Church in God in Christ. I learned how to to tithe and give then. A young woman. Amen.
Amen.
Last year on my birthday, this lady called me on the phone about an oddie. So I went and looked at it.
Amen.
I said, okay, that's nice, right there. It's good. I didn't need a car. I had a car. It was a 2019 Altman. It was running just fine. It was black, it was cute, and I was fine. All, it won't pay for it because it was still just 2 years old. So, but I said, okay, I'll come look at it. I looked at it, it was cute. I said, oh, she want to drive around? I said, oh, yeah, come on. I drove around, and then she said $55,000. I said, I said, well, Lord, you know, but it was a 2021. And it was on sale then. And I said, I said, the lady said, well, we can put you in it. I said, I bet you can. But as I was walking by the Mercedes place. I was walking by Mercedes. I said, ooh, that one's cute right there. I looked at it, and the man ran out there and brought me the keys and said, man, you want to drive? I said, no, that's okay. I said, but I'll see you tomorrow. I said, I'll see you tomorrow. The next day. I went home, y'all. This is what work does. I went and got on my knees, y'all. And I said, now, Lord, I do like that car. But if it takes all day, y'all know how when you go to the dealership, they give you that long spiel. You got to wait till every bank, da da da. Y'all know, y'all black people, y'all know. We got one, I'm just talking to us. Don't pay me no mind, okay? So, and it takes all day for you to get approved. Y'all know, hallelujah, I'm not the only one. My credit went to 800 right then. Hallelujah. Y'all know, amen. So I went and I said, now God, if this take all day, then I don't need it.
Amen. That's right.
So I got to the dealership, amen. The man filled out the papers, da 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 da. I was out in an hour and a half approved. The finance officer said, look, we had to take an additional $5,000 off the car to put you in it. And I said, oh, really? He said, then, Langley, I was the only one that wanted to approve you. I said, really? Honey, I went out and said, yeah. That was my baby. That's who I needed to approve my loan. Amen. My car payment won't but $20 more than what I was paying. My insurance didn't go up but $20 more than what I was paying. Now the gas price kind of scared me, but I'm still driving that Mercedes Benz. Amen. Praise the Lord. That's what God would do when you work for Him. So while I was giving my tithes and my offering, God was finding a way so I can get what I need. That's the kind of God we serve. Amen. He'll do it. He teach that it will profit you. Matthew 16 said, let your light shine before men that they may see your good works. Now this means now you got to have some standards. Okay, you are a Christian now.
Amen.
You're saved now.
Yes.
There are some things we supposed to change.
Yes.
We can't stay the same, amen?
Yes.
We know God is forgiving, amen, but still, hey, wait a minute.
Amen.
We know we got to meet Him in the air.
Amen.
You need to know what He going to say.
Amen.
So your work will count.
That's right.
Amen. I want my crowns. Hallelujah.
That's it.
I already got my door. I know it got to be shiny silver because I love silver.
Yeah.
So I already said, but he didn't say pearls. I said, well, God, if you could just change that pearls to, you know, silver, we'd be all right. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
That's what the Bible teaches. Let your light shine.
Yeah.
That we may see your good works and glorify. You are an example. Everybody is not reading the Bible. They reading you. You are the walking Bible. Amen. You are. So there's standards to this. Amen. The Bible also teaches us in 1 Corinthians 15:15. Therefore, my beloved brother, be steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord. Amen.
Yeah.
Always. always.
Always.
To the single people.
Amen.
You need to be in church
24/7. Amen. Preach, preach, preach.
You have nobody to answer to.
Amen.
So my pastor always said, "You always." I said, "Well, pastor, because I'm single and the word tell me I'm supposed to be here, so I shows up."
Amen.
What can I do?
Amen.
To the married people.
Amen.
Come together, you and your husband and wife. Y'all come together, figure this out. How we gonna work in the church together and still make home groovy? Amen. Amen. Yes. That's what we're supposed to be. Unmovable. Always abounding. Amen. Because you don't want your labor not to be in vain. Amen. Philippians 2:12 says, "Therefore, my beloved, as we have always obeyed, not as my presence only, but now much in my absence, work out your own salvation with fear and trembling."
Work it out.
I don't need to come to you. You need to come to you. You know what's going on with you. Fix you. Don't try to fix me. Fix you. And maybe we'll get this thing together. Amen. If we get this together. Amen. I think we can win some souls, Bishop, when we get us together. Stop pointing out the dress too short. You want her to have a long one? Go get it.
Amen.
Amen.
Stop talking about people earrings. The Lord will work it out. He worked it out for me.
Amen.
I found I had to bring my dress down too. Amen.
Amen.
When I came here, my dress was a little short. Guess what I did? I brought this robe. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Just act like we got some sense. Amen.
Amen.
And God will bless us.
Amen.
People are looking at us.
Amen.
Amen.
Y'all have to remember.
Yes.
Just please remember this.
Mm-hmm.
It's spiritual second.
Yes.
We live in the natural first.
Amen.
It's in the word.
Amen.
Y'all go look it up because I ain't got that down there. But it's in the word. Amen.
Amen.
It's in the word.
Amen.
So work out your soul salvation. What you need to make you better.
Amen.
There's a song we sing at New Hope. It says, "Make me better."
Amen.
That's a song. When y'all go YouTube that song, "Make me better."
Make me better.
That's all we want to do. Lord, just make me better.
Amen.
Because if I make me better, maybe I can help somebody else be better.
That's
why we are saved. That's why we're sanctified. That's why we got the Holy Ghost. So it can make us better. And I'm about to close.
Amen.
I charge all of you today, all to the pastor, to the congregation, to watch what God will do. If you continue to watch, and you continue to endure, and you continue to word, God will be there for you.
Amen.
God, when we stay true to God, God will stay true to us.
Yes.
We serve that kind of God.
Yes.
Walk by faith and not by sight.
Yes.
Trust God.
Uh-huh.
Bishop already said, lean not to your own understanding.
Amen.
Amen. Just trust God.
Yes.
If we start trusting God just some more.
Yes.
Ask God.
Yes.
I went home and said, now God, if this is going to be hard, you know, I got to sit here 8 hours to get approved. I know this is not for you.
Right.
I just keep the car I got because it's running. Won't nothing wrong with it.
Right.
Just start talking to him.
That's right.
That might just sound like prayer. I won't pray. I just needed to talk to God. I'm communicating right now.
Amen.
It ain't got to be a big fashion. Amen.
Amen.
He know you.
Amen.
He made you so he know you.
Amen.
He know your desires.
Amen.
He knows your heart. Amen.
Amen.
He just trying to stay in it.
Amen.
He just want to be in it.
Amen.
He want to be all part of you. He loves us. That he want us around him all the time.
Amen.
The Bible says, if you ask anything in my name,
yes.
He said he'll do it.
Yes.
It's not that hard.
Amen.
His name is what? Jesus.
Jesus.
So we ask anything in Jesus' name.
Yes.
He said he can do it.
Amen.
He also said, whatever situation you get in, I will never leave you nor forsake you. Yes, COVID came. Yes, it hit us hard. Yes, it took away some of our loved ones or friends. Yes, it did. But we are still left here to keep going. Hallelujah. And remember, whenever you feel like you can't do it, pull up Philippians and say, I can do all things through Christ who strengthened me.
Amen.
Tell the Lord, I can do it only because of you. And let me leave you with this. The best way is to get God's attention.
Amen.
Prayer is one.
Yes.
But the other one is praise.
Yes.
Amen.
God want a people that will worship him and praise him.
Yes.
For just because he's God.
Yes.
He wants you to love on him.
Yes.
Then when you feel that great joy come, then that strength will show up.
Yes.
Because the joy of the Lord is my strength.
Yes.
Amen.
Then when we step out and don't understand something, we don't know why the fire came to the home. We don't know why they took my mother. We don't know why you took my father. We don't know why I lost the car. We might not know why the house had to go. We don't know why we had to end up in the hospital. We might not know why some things. But take this word with you when you go through things. And we know that all things work together for the good of them that love God and to them who are called to his purpose. You are called today. Give it to God and he will bless you. I charge you today. Amen. Watch God. Watch what he will do for you when you put it all in his hand. Bless the Lord. Let us pray. Our God, our Father, certainly thank you, God, for this service on today. God, continue to bless the man of God. Watch over him. Send an angel by his side every night, oh God. Fill him with your joy and wisdom, oh God, that you have done for 16 years, oh God, that he can go on no more, God. Then God, touch his wife, his sidekick, oh God, his loved one, oh God, who's standing beside him each and every day, praying for him, oh God. Give her more strength, oh God, and more power, God, to go on, oh God. Then the people, oh God, here, oh God, at True Heart, nourish them the more, God. Give them an intimate word from God that will bless them, oh God, that they can continue to go on in this ministry, oh God. Let them be not only for themselves, let them be helpers of one another as we grow in Christ, oh God. God, teach us, oh God, to worship you more, to love you more. You told us to enter into your gates with thanksgiving, oh God, and to your courts with praise. God, let that be our determination when we walk in every Sunday. So when the man of God come forth to break the word, oh God, it will be even easier, oh God. Touch the heart of the people, oh God. Anything that they have need of, God, on today, oh God, bless them. Bless them, oh God. And as we go through this 16th year, oh God, for Pastor Porter, oh God, let the monies that was not even expected be even more. Blow his mind, oh God. Blow his mind, oh God. Give him what he need, oh God, for this ministry. As they open up some more doors for people to come through, oh God. As he raised pastors, oh God, in this church to grow, oh God. And even if I be one of them, God, have your way, God. Use us, God, as never before, oh God. We thank you now, God, for what you're going to do from October to November, oh God. It is never over, oh God, because you are still in charge. And thank you for your love. Thank you for Jesus who died on the cross and gave us life and gave it more abundantly. We thank you for the Holy Ghost that reigns in us, oh God. That is a correction, oh God. It is a guide and our teacher. We thank you, God. You thought so much of us that you gave us three in one. We thank you for the Trinity, oh God. Father, as we go home, but we're not going home yet, God, because we got another service to attend, and I'm going to try to get back in time, oh God. But have your way if I can't make it back, oh God. God, let it just be a blessing for everyone, oh God. Thank you, God. We just tell you thank you for your goodness, your grace, and your mercy. In Jesus' name, I pray, amen and amen. God bless you.
Something was said that came across your door that helped you, that prompted you, and you ought to be able to say, God, I thank you. Amen. But the Bible is saying, in all of your getting, get an understanding. Amen. And she really preached and poured her heart out and lay prosperous before the Lord. Amen. I love people. I love people that can glorify God for not just stuff that you hear that you that you love. You know, some people praise God when it's good for them.
Amen.
Yes. I got no help in here today.
Amen.
But when it's something you don't really want to bear, you know, she came down your street, rung your doorbell. With, you know, I don't hear people come in the office on various Sundays and they'll stop by because it was something that they wanted.
Yes.
Pastor, you really preached today. And then the next week, they'll come right by the door and won't say nothing.
Amen.
Like I didn't preach that day. And I learned that they liked what they heard. But when they, but you know, none of us like Castro.
That's nasty. Tell it.
But it works.
Amen.
Yeah, that, that. My mom used to warm it up on the stove, put some hot water, and put it in there, and I'd be just as happy. You know, you ain't going to school today. Yeah, you gotta go to school. I go in the kitchen and that hot water boiling with that casserole.
Uh huh. Yeah, you go.
Yeah. Some of y'all know what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
Some of your older people.
Yeah, they'll
give it to you when it's hot.
Yeah.
The spoon. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Go lay down. About 30 minutes to an hour.
Yeah.
And then I was beginning to realize why I ain't go to school today.
Uh-huh.
But the next morning, you was ready.
Amen.
And every now and then, God would send a medicine woman.
Amen.
Medicine man.
Uh-huh.
Come by and give us. Amen. She preached her heart out.
Amen.
Amen. Yeah, she preached her heart out.
Yeah.
She told us that we all supposed to work. Why? Because God worked.
Amen.
I don't know about y'all, but that should have hit home to everybody in this church.
Amen.
Mm-hmm. Somebody laying around, ain't working, ain't got a job, they ain't gonna clap.
Amen.
They ain't gonna clap because they ain't working.
That's right.
Then you talked about how we supposed to pour out and pay our tithes, and God could have asked for more, and he only asked for 10%. See, I'm pastor. I'm searching the room where you preaching. I'm looking at faces. I'm looking at folk who ain't standing up clapping. I said, yeah, they ain't tired, and that's why. Mm-hmm. Somebody said, my oldest son, Jay, was saying, Amen. But we bless God for her today. Give God another hand of praise. First lady, y'all have really sent some teachers here. I've enjoyed every last one to the full. I'm just so happy. I will be tuning in on next Sunday at 2 to hear that word again. You know what you just did? You just not only blessed this church, you about to bless the airway. On next Sunday at 2 o'clock, that word going to be going out the airway and folk going to get that word. That's what I love, what God is doing, and folk miss it. You think it's about True Heart got a radio us. We're on the radio. Yes. No, God's not only, he's blessing this house and turn around next Sunday and send that same word out. He sent that word out to Portsmouth, Chesapeake, Norfolk, Suffolk, Franklin, Williamsburg, Smithfield, all them places, just hearing the word that we getting it here. We just get it first.
Amen.
We'll get that later, Holy Spirit. Text me when y'all get that. We get it first in here. And you ought to be glorifying God. Because God's word don't change.
Amen.
I always say it doesn't matter who preaching, as long as they preaching the word. I got it up in here. Amen. Amen. We about to go home. We're gonna allow minister to come back at this time and give us our benediction.
Amen.
And then she's gonna come in her own way, give us our benediction.